And welcome back, folks. Welcome back to the Loot 'em Dare game marathon. You know the drill by now. We are playing G211 Park Place, a game that, had some interesting visuals, and therefore I chose to play it. Let us start. Take a shower. As you can see, it has this mid-90s PlayStation 1 era aesthetic, which actually a few games recently tried to pull off, namely some horror games, which obviously were inspired by the first Resident Evil game. One of them is called Vaccine, which apparently is not very good, but there was another one which I think was okay. Oh yeah, let us actually do what we are supposed to do. You can't jump. I always find first-person games where your character cannot jump to be claustrophobic. Something just feels wrong not being able to jump. I don't know. Trash disposal. How do you actually you click with your left mouse button. Okay. Your character is extremely slow, but the mouse is extremely sensitive for some reason. Yeah, I like the visuals quite a bit. It looks really cool, I think. Okay, let us take a shower. Shower curtain. Not sure why it can't show us the showering process itself. This game actually, it reminds me a bit of A Week's Passing, which of course, turned out not to be so great. How do you actually open the door? I don't want to. Supply chute food. Okay. Apparently, we live in the future where you just pull a lever. Even though it brings up the question why they have levers in the future. Well, anyway, you just press a lever and then you get a food box that is two-dimensional and semi-transparent for some reason. I guess we just. Yeah, and then. Things just fall to the floor, and we magically ate them, apparently. We should probably actually dispose of the trash. Now we need to find that apple that. Okay, that I can't reach. Anyway. So we need to pick up. Didn't I already recycle? That's great. No, I didn't, apparently. Okay. We need to pick up the work briefs. Okay. Commute to work. Let me guess. I press a lever for. No, I don't press a lever. Okay, how do I actually commute to work then, if I can't leave this apartment? That's a paper. And the paper ball has reappeared for some reason. Okay, yeah. Now it really, it very much, even more paper balls. Now it really reminds me of the other game, A Week's Passing. Why is everything littered with litter? Is this a joke? Oh, please back your trash. Well, I don't have any back, trash bag, so this will have to do. Okay. And then I don't even need to step into the shower in order to shower. Because the game thinks, that is unnecessary. Okay. We eat some food. We fetch our work briefs. Clear up trash. Okay, now we need to clear up the trash. For some reason. No, we still don't have... We still don't have a trash bag. And the collision detection... works a bit strange. Okay, anyway. And maybe their numerical integration scheme is unstable, or they actually implemented... Oh, there is a trash bag. I did this completely wrong. Okay. They actually implemented... wind or air movement. Now the... did not disappear. I wonder whether you can actually bag a bag in a bag. I think you can. Let us continue bagging bags in bags. Haha. Something feels oddly satisfying about that plop sound. Okay, I was afraid that this game would be horrible, but so far it is actually not. I mean, it's not brilliant either. It's not a second Stanley Parable, but certainly, it manages to keep my attention. Something. And the game decided to crash. And I restarted the game and played up to the point where we were. Basically, before the game crashed. I mean, I played up until the point where the game asks you to clear up the trash. Now we shouldn't, Now I won't screw around with that trash so much. Let's hope the game does... Okay, it didn't crash this time. The machine, the supply machine, seems to be in need of repair. Call for repairs, yeah. We need to use the telephone. Fetch work briefs. That is also not brilliant. Sleep. Okay, let us sleep amidst all that garbage. Take a shower. Eat some food. The machine is still... We actually don't need to really grab any new food. I don't know whether it's a smart idea to throw away these briefing documents, but anyway. Paper bill. Ball. No, not bill. Okay, it doesn't really tell me what to do anymore. Okay, can't commute to work. Do I need to call the repairs again? I'm not sure what, what the game expects me to do, and whether this is actually intentional or whether it's another bug. It would be a bit of a weird ending if that were the ending. But there's nothing else I can. I mean, I can get more food boxes, certainly. I can't get any more. Maybe that was supposed to happen. Maybe we just need to keep recycling things until something happens. I hope something happens. Yeah, and I back to backs again. Okay, somehow I don't think this apartment is getting any cleaner. Let me just try to. I was just checking some keys. Something seems to be amiss. Okay, I'm really not sure what you're supposed to do here. Maybe this is actually the end of the game. It's a bug. Well, anyway, this was G211 Park Place. An interesting little game set in a little world. I really like the aesthetics though. I mean, yeah. Maybe it is just nostalgia, but I think it's more than that, because I think the low res graphics actually give this sort of like a bit of an unreal quality. It sort of makes this whole game feel more like, I mean, yeah. So the lack of realism is, I think it's actually a good thing. And the more stylized look, yeah, makes this sort of gives it a bit of an alien feel. Or maybe even, yeah, the feeling as if we were inside a painting or something like that. Anyway, so yeah, this was G211 Park Place. As always, there's a link to the game in the description, and I hope to see you in the next video. So until next time, folks, until then.